Hey, it's Miss Nitya. Okay, I will not mark the attendance now. Okay, but I'll be marking the attendance like maybe around 3 o'clock to ensure every one of you guys join until the end. Okay, and some of you guys requested to leave 30 minutes earlier because you have tuition classes at 4 o'clock, so we understand that. Okay, so we would like to welcome you guys for our first virtual science clinic for 2021. Okay, we had no much chance last year to have a clinic. Okay, I hope this time, okay, we will be able to join all the clinics virtually. Since it's virtual, you don't have to worry about transport and, you know, anything. You can just join and listen. Okay, and today's clinic will be very helpful for you guys to be prepared for City 1. Okay, so because we have chosen the topics, okay, which are very general, okay, which are also very important for your checkpoint, okay, and we'll be assisting you guys to understand and score well in City 1. Okay, so all in one. Okay, so if you guys are with me, I need you guys to thumbs up. Thumbs up. Not much. So this 45 of you guys are hardworking one because I have two devices. Ms. Reno has one device. So all 45 of you guys are hardworking ones. So I don't have to worry much. No, all 47 are hardworking, including me and Ms. Reno as well. Thank you.
49 ready then.
Okay, guys. So today our first topic will be talking about density and also pressure. Okay, yes. Okay, guys. So today we will be looking into few physics topics, which is really, really important in your checkpoint. Okay, and also you will be learning about density and pressure. Until your IGCSE, okay, even if you want to continue your higher education in engineering, so this will be one of the important topics, okay? So it's important for us to understand the basics about density and pressure, okay? So density is easy. Let me explain by drawing. Okay, guys, so let's say I have let's say this is a parking lot, okay? And parking lot A and B. Do you guys know what is parking lot? It's the place where you park your car. If you go to shopping mall, okay, there will be some space for you to park your car, okay? Okay, so let's say here, okay, there are space for 10 cars. So here I have 1, 2, 3, are you, my cars are so busy. Okay, here I have 8 cars. Here I have only 3 cars. Which parking lot is densely packed? Which parking lot is densely packed? You can respond in chat box. Ms. Reno, you need to change the the settings for chat, because I will always make sure they can only chat with the host.
Yeah, so they can chat.
Yes. So
today, now I change it to public for today's session.
Okay, yeah. And guys, let's chat about relevant topics to our science clinic today. Okay, so Kishan said B, Parvin said B, Boon, Muhammad, Mikhail, Daniel, and Anna. Okay, these are the names that I will always see in the chat box. Okay, I want everyone to mention. So it's easy. So as we can see in the picture, as we can understand, we know parking lot B is densely packed. Okay, why? Because the number of cars. Am I right? The number of cars. Okay, and then let's say.
But why, Burf? Why you put A? Do you still confuse about density? Why your answer is A?
Maybe he wants to be different than others.
Then the marks also will be different, isn't it?
Yeah, Miss Renuka taught you guys about density. So yeah, you cannot say I don't know anything about density now.
Yeah, today okay. Also we did questions. That means you are not focusing in class, Vaibhav.
Vaibhav, you are center of attraction today. Wait, B. He was confused. You huh? know, it's Friday, the Friday vibes. Okay, he was confused. I mistakenly put A. Do not blame him. He understands everything. He pays attention. So, okay, guys. So, you know, now looking at the number of cars, we know parking lot B is densely packed. Pay attention to the word dense. Dense, okay? So, densely means we are talking, when we say densely, we are talking about the density, okay? So, let's say I have, now I have, okay, two boxes. Box A and box B. Okay, I have five balls in each box. Okay, and here, this ball, each ball has a mass of 1 kilogram. But here, each box has 2 kilogram. Okay, and the total volume of A and B are the same. So can someone tell me now which box is densely packed? It's denser. I'm supposed to switch the option, right? It's okay. B is my favorite alphabet on every Friday. Okay, guys. So, yeah. But I saw one A just now. Kishan.
Kishan.
Vaibhav and Kishan. Because these people are A student, you know. They can't think about B. They are A student. So it must be A all the time. Oh, Kishan, interesting. Teacher, I wrongly typed. Okay. Okay, guys. So, you know, the number, okay, density is all about, okay, the mass. So just now when we see, like, we had 8 cars and we had 3 cars. Why did we choose the parking lot with 8 cars as the denser one? Because 8 cars has bigger mass, but the volume are the same. Okay, so that's how we compare. But here is the same. We have the same number of balls, but in B, the balls are heavier. Okay, so the mass in B increases, causing B to be densely packed. Okay, it will become denser, heavier and denser. Okay? Okay, guys. So now, can someone help me to define what is dense?
Ms. Nitya, we can't hear you. Ms. Nitya, we can't hear you.
I wanted to annotate, but I pressed on mute. I'm sorry, guys. You know, the Friday vibe. Okay.
I thought I'm the only one couldn't hear.
Oh, you are the only one who couldn't hear?
I'm not sure because I'm the one like saying we can't hear, we can hear, but I can see a student answering the question, so I'm not sure.
Oh, okay, yeah. Okay, guys, so what is density? So some are sending me the formula, teachers. Density is mass divided by volume. Okay, so what does it mean? First of all, before you memorize, you understand the formula, you need to know what does it mean. Okay, it's about the total mass of a substance, okay, in a certain volume. Okay, the total mass of a substance in a certain volume. The mass will be affected either because of the number of particles, okay, in the substance or because of the mass of the particles in a substance. Okay, so that is what we call as density. Density is about a mass of a substance, okay, in a certain volume. So whenever you want to compare density of objects, okay, for example, let's say you want to compare density of a feather and a wooden block. Okay, in order to compare, okay, make sure the volumes are the same. You compare the same volume, okay? Then you measure the mass. The heavier one will be denser, okay? That's what it means by density. If you guys understand, give me a thumbs up. If you don't, then tell me, teacher, can you please explain? I don't understand. Okay, let's choose some other. Okay, if you understand, you give me a thumbs up. Can you guys hear me? Renu, yes, I know you can hear. Not that Renuga, not that Renu. This Renu. I'm so sorry. Renu? Okay, yes. So you guys understand, right? Okay, good. So whoever who don't understand, can you please put in the chat box? You tell me, miss, I don't understand. Please repeat. I'll do it for you guys. Even if one person says that, I will repeat. Okay. So yes, density means. Okay, so density means the mass of a substance in a certain volume. Okay, it will be measured by the mass, kilogram or gram, okay, divided by the volume, cm cube. Guys, do not make mistake. You know, whenever you guys learn pressure and density together, what you guys will do, you will get confused. Okay, so for pressure, you will divide the force by area. You should divide the force by area. But yeah, what you will do is divide the force by volume. But here, you guys tend to switch. Okay, so in order for you guys to get the formula right, what you need to know is you need to understand it better. Density is about, okay, how compact or the mass of a substance over a certain volume. Volume, okay, remember that, okay? So, this is what density means, okay? So, density will be different in a different state of matter, okay? We need to know. So, we know this is solid. This is liquid. And this is gas. Okay. So let's say all of their volume are same. Let's say 10 cm cube. Let's assume 10 cm cube. Let's assume 10 cm cube. Okay.
Miss Nitya, okay. Yes. There is a question from Hariza. Okay. So can you repeat the definition?
The definition of density, once more, I didn't catch that. Okay. So, density is about a mass of a substance, okay, in a certain volume. As we have learned in periodic table, different element has different mass. Remember? Different atoms has different mass, different elements has different mass, isn't it? Okay. So, this is what makes one substance is the density of one substance is different than the density of another substance. Okay, so this is the reason why we learn about density. Density is about the mass of a substance, okay, in a certain volume. Usually when we compare the density, we will compare per unit volume. That means per 1 cm cube or 1 meter cube. Okay, this is why we divide by the volume. To know what is the mass of a substance, okay, per unit volume, okay, then we will be able to compare the density, okay. And then now when we look at the different state of matter, okay, so when we talk about density, density differs for different substance, okay, due to the different mass of the atoms, okay. But when we look at the different state of matter, of same substance, for example, let's say this is water. Okay, let's say this is water. This is water, isn't it? Okay, so when they are in a different state of matter, okay, the number of particles in each state of matter will be different. Why? Due to the space in between the particles, right? Okay, so when you have ice cube of the same volume, it will be much more heavier, okay, then water of the same volume, okay, then the gas, So can someone tell me why? Why the density of this water at different state of matter is different? Can someone tell me that? Mass is weight. Weight is how much heavy thing is. Okay. Mass is about the total total matter in a substance. Okay. So my body mass is all about all the cells, tissues, the blood, everything in my body. Okay. But weight is affected by the gravity pull. Okay, if you go to if you're on Earth and if you go to the moon, okay, your body mass will be the same, but your body weight will be different because of the different gravity. That is the difference, okay, between mass and weight. Okay, so always use the word mass. Okay. Okay, guys, can I choose someone to answer? Will that be okay? No? Miss, enough of torturing us during lessons. Why should we answer even during science? I can hear your mind voice. Let me answer you guys. Guys, you see, the number of particles per unit volume here are more than in gas. Why? Because in gas, the particles move away and there are more space between the particles. Okay, so this causes to have less number of particles, okay, per unit volume in gas. Is that clear, guys? This is why gas, okay, the same volume, okay, but when they are in the state of matter of gas, it will have less density compared to liquid and solid. So let's say solid, I'll label it as A. Liquid, I'll label as B. So can someone tell me which is denser at a certain volume, at the same volume? A or B? Denser, this time it's not B. Kishan and Viber will be very happy to answer this time. Okay, A. Why? Because in solid, the particles are packly arranged. Okay, the number of particles will be higher in per unit volume in a given space. Okay, but in liquid, there will be some space between the particles, so the number of particles in the same volume will be lesser. So this is what causes the liquid to have less density compared to solid. Okay. Okay, guys, so I'll clear. Then let's move on to the next. Okay, so what's in the slide is what I've explained just now. So mass is the measurement of the amount. Mass is the measurement of the amount of matter or stuff in an object measured in grams. Okay, so mass usually measured in gram. Okay, unless the question requires you to change it into kilogram, then you use kilogram. It depends on the question. Okay, let's say in question they say an object has a mass of 30 gram. Okay, and a volume of 10 cm cube. Find the density. Since they did not ask you to change anything, so you just find in gram per cm cube. Unless if you request, if they request you to change, okay, the unit, then you need to change. Is that clear, guys? Thumbs up if it's clear. Thumbs up. Renu, how many thumbs up are there? Miss Renu? Ms. Renu?
Sorry, I was muted. 35, almost 40. Because some of them comes out a bit late, so the number run away.
Okay, so after this, I'm gonna... Kishan? No, Kishan. So like after this, I think we will use raise hand. Okay. Okay, so we have looked into the three states of matter, which are solid, liquid, and gas. Okay, and then we have also compared the density. Okay, so volume, sometimes, okay, they will not tell you what is volume. So why is this teacher talking about density is about mass in a certain volume, mass in a certain volume? What is volume? Volume is the overall space taken up by the substance. Okay, if you have a balloon, okay, and you fill in air, okay, so the overall space taken by the air is the volume. Okay, and then let's say if you have a regular object with a regular shape, okay, then you can measure the size and calculate the volume. Okay. So how to measure the volume? Usually, like in the questions, okay, when they give you, sometimes they will give you volume. Sometimes they will make it a little tricky by just giving you the picture of the box, okay, and they will give you the measurements, the dimension of the box, the height, length, and width. Then they will ask you guys to find the volume, or they will not talk about volume at all. They will say find the density. If that happens, okay, how are you going to find the volume of the substance? Easy. What you need to do is, in order to find volume, the length times width times height. Okay, if it is a regular object, you can apply this if it is a square or a rectangle. Okay, let's say if I give you a container. Are you don't want that? Okay, let's say I give you a container, a cylindrical container. So can someone tell me how to find the volume of this cylindrical container? Guys? Okay, let me choose. Let me roughly choose Samrat. Long time no see, Samrat. So Samrat, do you know how to measure volume of a cylinder? Hi Samrat. Any idea? Oh, your mic is not connected. Nushaiba?
Yes, miss.
Okay. Do you have any idea on how to calculate the volume of cylinder?
Volume of cylinder.
Yeah.
First, we need to find the circle, area of the circle, pi r squared times it by the height of the cylinder.
Okay. Always find the area of the base. Area of the base. Okay, area of the base will be pi r square, and then when you calculate the height times with the height. Okay, that's all. Okay, I think this will be helpful for you guys in maths as well. Okay, you guys have learned this in maths. If you tell me no, then I'll communicate with your mathematics teachers. Okay, so usually measured in milliliters, but usually in checkpoint, we will refer to cm cube. In checkpoint, we will refer to CMQ. Okay. That's on volume. So moving on here. So let's crack our tiny brain. So which do you think will have the greater volume? Which do you think will have greater volume? The feather or rock? But you look at the mass, they have the same mass. They have the same mass, but what about the volume? So, same? Are you sure? They have the same mass, but what about the volume? The feather will have greater volume. If they say both the material has the same mass, okay, and same volume, then they will have same density, okay? If I say both of them have same density and same mass, then they should have same volume. But here, what they have mentioned, both of the materials, they have the same mass. A feather, okay, a feather, okay, will be lighter, right? Usually a feather will be lighter. So in order to have 1 kilogram, you need more feathers. But rocks, usually they are heavier. In order to have 1 kilogram, we just need a smaller volume. So when we compare the volume, the feathers will have greater volume than the rocks. Okay? But there is a trick in this question. Which has the greater mass? Which has the greater mass? Yes, Parvin is the same. Samira, Kishan, Yash. Okay, good. Good job. Okay, many of you guys are sending the answers. Good job, guys. Okay, so if you compare, okay, both of them will have same mass. Why? So you just pay attention to the slide. You can see 1 kg and 1 kg. That's simple as that. Okay? Okay. So, Okay, so now let's look into how to define density. Usually in exams or whenever they ask you guys to define density, you're not going to say how packed is a substance or what, or it's based on the mass of the atom in the substance. No. Okay, it's just short. Do you guys remember just now when I asked you guys what is density? What you have said is the mass divided by volume was the equation, right? Okay, so how to define that? Density is mass per unit volume, mass per unit volume. Or if you if you can't really remember this, miss, it's too much. Okay, so whatever you you need to write down what you understand. Okay, so how to write down is a mass of a substance, okay, in a certain volume. That's all. Mass of a substance in a certain volume. Okay, that's what you guys need to remember. So what is mass? Mass is the amount of matter. Amount of matter. That is mass. That's the definition for mass. Okay, within a certain volume. Okay, so this, both this definition will be accepted. You know, density is defined as mass per unit volume. But what is mass? The definition of mass is the amount of matter in a substance. That is mass. Okay, and then amount of matter in a certain volume or within a certain volume. Okay, guys. So as we have learned now, okay, so can someone help me? Okay, not someone. I want everyone to answer. We have A and B. So which square is more dense? This, we are recalling whatever I've been talking about since we have started. Or B, 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 B. Someone sent B, 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 B. Who sent? Wilson. Excited. Okay, yes. Everyone sent B. Okay, we know when the volume are the same. You see here, okay, volume of boxes are same, right? Okay, but you see the number of particles are different, so the mass will be different. Okay, so which one is denser? B is denser. Good job, guys. Okay, so now which one is denser? Which one is denser? So everyone are saying, I think I saw B in A. So now Daniel is excited. Are you answering behalf of everyone in this session? The smaller one. Okay, the smaller square. Okay, yeah. I did not label, but you guys understood, right? A and B. A, why the mass? The mass is the same, but volume smaller, right? The mass is the same because why? Because we have five balls or five particles in each of the boxes, okay? But what about the volume? A has a lesser volume than B. So which one is more dense? A. Okay, yes, you are right, A. Okay, so I can see you guys understand density better now. Okay, but not yet, but this is density in solid. What about density of liquid? Okay. So when we compare density of liquid, hold on, there will be some calculations. Okay. Okay, guys, so how to compare density of liquid, okay? Let's say you have two different liquid, okay, in a two different container. We will calculate as how we always calculate, okay? Measure the mass of the liquid, okay, and then divided by the overall volume, okay. Or if the chemicals do not mix together, for example, let's say you have a salt, melted salt, okay, melted salt alone, okay, and water. You mix them together, the salt will dissolve in water. They will mix together, okay. If you have water and oil, they don't mix together. Okay, so what you can do, you can add them into the same container. The liquid that has lower density will float. The liquid that has lower density will float. Okay, the liquid that has higher density will sink. Is that clear? So this is why if you take one feather and a small rock stone, okay, throw it in water, what will happen? The feather will float because it's less denser. Okay, the stone will sink because it is denser. That's what density is all about. Okay, but learning about denser, so now all this while we have been trying to understand the concept about density. Okay, but how to apply it? Let's say you want to find density of a substance. Okay, so you are given a substance and people say, okay, find the density of this substance. We know how the theory, we know the definition. Density is the mass of a substance in a certain volume. Okay, so that's what we know. But how to apply, how to find the density of a substance? Okay, so we need to know, first of all, we need to know how to find the mass of an object. How to find mass of an object, guys? What do we do to find the mass of an object? I'm going to put the object on my hand and I'm going to roughly estimate. Okay, this, I think it should be 2 kg. I think this should be 1 kg. Is that right? Can you estimate? Can we assume something in science? Science is all about quantity, the accurate quantity. Okay, so when you want to measure mass, Marisa, I know, but here, let's say you don't know what is the density, you don't know what is the volume. How are you going to measure the mass of an object? Not if I say calculate, then you're going to put in the values in the formula, you're going to find the answer. If I say measure, you're going to have a weighing scale. You know, you need to have a weighing scale or electronic balance. Okay, in checkpoint, we will always use the top pen balance. Okay, whatever is shown in the picture is the top pen balance. Okay, so what you need to do, nothing much. Okay, you don't have to invent a machine to measure the mass. No, it's there. So you just need to know, in order to find density, I need mass and volume. So I need to measure mass. How to measure mass? Use weighing scale. Okay, weighing scale. Then measure the mass. Then you need to record the mass. Okay, or you use in checkpoint, they will always use top pen balance. That's their famous, that's their favorite top pen balance. Okay. Okay, but what we have in our laboratory is the electronic weighing machine, electronic. Okay, okay. So you find the mass, you measure using top pen balance. Why am I using top pen balance? Because it will be easier for you in checkpoint. Okay. Okay, then number two, find the volume of the object. Okay, so let's find out whether if the object is in a regular shape, you can measure the size. You can measure the size. Okay, you can measure the size. If it is in a regular shape, if it's in rectangle, square, or cylinder, even if it's cone, if it's a sphere, you can measure the volume, the size, and then you can calculate the volume. Okay, but what if I have let's say a substance, excuse me guys, okay, what if I have a substance in irregular shape? That means I cannot measure and get the accurate volume. So the person who can give me the method that we will use to measure, okay, the volume of irregular shaped object, I'll buy you guys breakfast on Monday. Let's make it on Tuesday, because on Monday I'll be in primary campus. On Tuesday, I'll buy you breakfast for Tuesday. Make the breakfast. '91 and '92, they won't be there to get break. But guys, now, earlier I promised you guys breakfast, and I say I will make it green tea and biscuits. Okay? Miss Renuka wants to answer that. Miss Renu, I will buy you another set of breakfast if you don't answer. Oh, yeah. So '91 and '92, they will not be there to say, trust my words, but this time I did mention MACD breakfast. MACD won't give you green tea. They will not give you healthy food. They will always give you unhealthy food. So yes. Wait, so no green tea. No green tea. I said MACD. Or now people, okay, now you guys want to ask what is the question. Okay, so MACD is good. Okay. Okay, guys. The question is, okay, how to find the volume of an irregular shaped object. If it's a square or if it's a cube, a cuboid, we can measure by hand. Viber, you became a machine that measures volume. Good. No breakfast for you. I'll make sure your parents know about this. And they don't give you cake. Pariza, you're almost there. Displacement. Did anyone else say displacement? No, I think Pariza is the only one. Displacement can. Yes. And Samira. Okay. So Pariza and Samira. But actually Pariza answered first. Pariza answered first. Pariza, are you coming online or physical? Pariza? Next week, online or physical? Online. Then how am I to buy you breakfast? You can deliver to my house. Okay, noted. share your address, then I'll buy for you. I'm serious. Okay, done. Okay, guys, you know, if you have irregular shape object, okay, so it's easier if you use the displacement method. Using what? Easy, using water. Okay, the first step, what you need to do, get a container in which you can measure the volume of a substance. So if you tell me, Miss, can I get a beaker? No. Okay, but Miss, can I get a measuring cylinder? Yes. But before that, you need to know what is beaker, what is measuring cylinder. Measuring cylinder, the measurements will be very accurate. Okay, so you take a measuring cylinder, okay, then you put it on the table. Then you add water, okay, of a certain known amount. Okay, maybe you add 100 cm cube. Okay, maybe I'll take a bigger measuring cylinder. I add 100 cm cube of water. Okay, then I'll measure the initial volume of water alone, which means the water alone is 100 cm cube. Okay. Yes, guys. Daniel, thank you. Concentrate. I know you guys are excited about the breakfast. Okay. But there will be more questions. Okay. So I will offer 5 breakfasts on Tuesday. So one is taken by Parisa. We have 4 more breakfasts. Okay. 4 more breakfasts. Okay. Okay, guys. Then. Okay, then what we do, you have a measuring cylinder, you have water. So now you're going to add in the object, okay, the irregular object. Okay, the irregular object. Okay, so you're going to add in the object into the cylinder containing water. Then the water will rise, isn't it? The water will be displaced. This is why we call it as displacement method, water displacement method. Okay, so the water will rise due to the object. If it's lighter than the water, it will float. What you do, you need to add on another substance to pull it down to make sure the object sinks. Okay, so that's another part. So here what you need to do is you need to add in the object. Okay, add in the object as we can see here. Okay, you see the spotlight? Okay, you need to add in the object. Okay, when you add in the object, the water will rise. The water will rise. Okay, so you need to wait until the water rises and then you measure the final volume. But this is water plus object. Okay, let's say 150 cm cube. Okay, so now can we find the volume of the object? Can we find the volume of the object? Bhavish, Sai, Kartik. So, Naren, do you think we can find the volume of the object now? Yes, the volume of the object will be the final volume. The final volume minus the initial volume. You will get the volume of object. That's how we measure the volume. See, right? It's easy. Okay, this is how people have been so creative by birth. You're going to starve for a lifetime. If your parents read these answers, you will not get breakfast, lunch, dinner for lifetime. If your parents see your answers. Okay. Okay. I mean, yes, you mean. But that's inhuman. I don't know. Okay. So guys, do you understand how to measure volume? So now we know how to measure mass. We know how to measure volume. Can we calculate the density? Yes, just substitute the values. substitute the value, make sure you write down the unit. Okay, so when for knowledge, you need to know that smell divided by volume. But for exam, it's important not to forget your unit. It's a must to write the unit. No unit, no marks. Remember, whatever you do must be perfect on the paper. Okay? So I think that's how we find the density. We measure the mass of an object, then we measure the volume. If it's regular, you just measure the dimension and calculate. If it's irregular object, you use water displacement method. Okay? And then what to do? You calculate by substituting or replacing the value in the formula. Okay? So is it okay, guys? Thumbs up if you understand. Good job. Ms. Reno, how many thumbs up did you get?
About 32.
32. So what about the rest? Okay. We are not supposed to. Miss, I sent my address to Miss Renuga.
Oh yeah, she just now sent in the chat. I think she accidentally sent to me. Later I will forward that message to Miss Nitya. No worries.
Okay. Thank you for trusting all my words. But I will. Okay? I will. Okay, guys. So we are done with this part. I understand that if you don't understand, you will ask me to repeat or you will ask me questions. Okay, guys, let's don't talk about food in the chat box now. All the biryani, vegetarian, please stop talking about it. Thank you. Okay, so you see, we are done with this part on how to measure. Okay, so let's look into this part is very important for your exam. Okay, city one, checkpoint, very, very important. I'm going to teach you guys now and I'm not going to repeat this. And you guys are going to remember this until your last day of your life. Until the last day of your life. Whenever you need to do a calculation in science, there are three steps that you need to know. First of all, in science, okay, until year 11, your university, whenever like whatever you study in science, whenever you want to do a calculation, even in mathematics, whenever you want to do a calculation which involves formula, make sure you always write down the formula. It's okay if you have to repeat it 100 times or 1,000 times. Density is always mass divided by volume. Make sure you write it down. This is the step one. Okay, so to find density, we need mass, volume, and then we find density, right? That's different. When you want to show solution, how to show solution? Solution, the first step, write down the formula. It's very important. Write down the formula. Okay, second step, what you need to do? Substitute the values. What is the mass? If the mass of an object is 35 gram and it takes up 7 cm³ of space, that means this is the volume. Calculate the density. Easy. What is the mass? You write it down. 35 divided by the volume is 7. Substitute the value will be the step two. But step two is incomplete. Step two is incomplete. So can you guys tell me what is missing in step two? Units, correct. Correct, Samira, units. Okay, correct. Okay. So unit. So what's missing here is the unit. So for mass, 35 gram. For volume, 7 cm³. So the answer, the third one will be the answer. So density will be 35 divided by 7. Make sure, okay, you are allowed to use your calculator. I had a student last time, you know, so whenever she used her brain to calculate, she can do it fast and it will be right. Whenever she uses a calculator, she will always give me wrong answer. She will always give me wrong answer. I don't know why, because she had no good relationship with the calculator. Make sure you practice using calculator at home, okay? Do not get calculator one day before the exam and you try to use, okay? Make sure you are really familiar with your own calculator. Okay? Okay. So when you calculate 35 divided by 7, 5. So the density is 5. You need, remember guys, okay? So when it's divided, here is divided, isn't it? So gram divided by centimeter cube. Okay guys, gram divided by centimeter cube. Okay, if you see any unit, let's say if gram times centimeter cube, okay, what you need to do, you just need to write the unit together. There is no divide sign or the slash sign. Okay, but if it's a division, remember gram divided by centimeter cube. Okay. So guys, if it's clear, go to reactions, raise hand. Go to reactions and raise hand. Ms. Renu?
It's still increasing, Veda. 32 only raised hand. Guys, what happened to the remaining 21? Are you guys here?
The others are in the La La Land, the Friday La La Land.
Okay, now reach up to 41. Still not enough.
Guys, if you don't raise hand, I will not know whether you are not paying attention. Vaibhav, I'm going to kill you. I'm not sure if you guys are not paying attention or you don't understand. Okay? So, make sure you respond to me.
Ms. Nita, sorry. There is a question from Faris.
Okay.
Is it compulsory to give unit during working? I thought it's only compulsory when giving answer.
You must give during working. Must. It's a must. Why? To avoid careless mistakes. It is important to avoid careless mistake. During exam, you might get panic. Okay, you might even remember, after the exam, you won't even remember what you wrote on the paper. Okay, because of the situation. So it's always good to practice writing down the unit every time. I know it's a little tiring, and then, you know, to keep writing the unit, keep writing the formula for all the questions, but you must. Don't ask me about units anymore. It's a must. You listen to me now, you'll be very grateful later. Okay, you will tend to save a lot of marks. You will tend to save a lot of marks, which you might lose due to careless mistake. So it's a must to write down the formula all the time, to write down the unit all the time. You have no other choice. I'm not giving you guys any other choice. It's a must. Okay? Okay, guys, so means if we don't put in units during working, will the marks get deducted, right?
Yeah.
Yes, the marks will get deducted if the marks are given for the solution. Okay.
There will be marks allocated for the question will be different. Sometimes they only allocate 1 mark, sometimes 3 marks, sometimes 2 marks. So you won't know when they will give you marks for the unit and not for the unit. So why you want to take the risk? Every time they give you question, calculation question, you just do the proper working with the unit and final answer, you must give unit. And in the calculation also, please show the unit. Okay, because the allocation of marks will be different sometimes. So you don't know whether they are giving you marks for the calculation or not. So as a best practice, please include units every time.
So Wilson said keyword units, lol. Okay. Okay, guys, so let's clear. So this is what I showed to you guys earlier. You see the formula. Substitute the values, the answer with the unit. Okay, it is a must to do this. Remember the three-step formula. Can stop, raise hand. You're not raising your real hand. Okay, it's okay, guys. Lower your hand now. Daniel is so worried about raising hand. Okay, guys. So make sure you write down the unit. Okay, follow the three steps. Okay. So next one, I'm not going to pay much attention to all the questions. Okay, but we're going to do one or two. The rest, you can try at home. And if you don't understand, if you can't do, okay, or you want to check your answer, you can check during the revision week with hers. Okay, next, during our next lesson. I will only be away on Monday. Tuesday, I'm all yours. I belong to year 9 Becker King. Okay. Okay, so guys, here let's try to solve some density problems together. Okay, let's do number one. Frank has a paper clip. It has a mass of 9 grams and a volume of 3 cm³. Okay, so let me show to you guys. First, you need to write the formula. Density equals to mass divided by volume. That is, this will be the step one. Okay, this will be the step one. Step two, I'm using blue. Step two will be substitute the value. So density will be, what is the mass? 9 grams. Okay, divided by the volume. 3 cm³. 9 divided by 3. Make sure you have a good relationship with your brain now so that it calculates and gives you correct answer. So it should be 3 grams. Divide, right? Divide cm³. Remember this, guys. This is the easiest way to remember. First, we have formula. Good job. We already substitute the correct value. Good job. We have the answer with unit. Good job. I'm genius. I'm smart. If you have done the same, then we are in one category. We are the smart people. Okay? Okay, guys. Choose another question for me to... It's all about calculating density. So can you guys try it at home? And you can refer to us during your science lesson. Okay? We will only focus on this density. If you don't understand, you can ask, Miss, the page number, this one. We will share the notes with you guys during our lesson. Okay? We will share the notes. Okay? Or we can even blast the notes. I can compile all the notes, blast in my message. You guys can download from there. Okay? Then you guys can try at home. And you can always refer to me or Ms. Renuka anytime whenever you guys need help. Okay? So we are the good people. So we will help you guys no matter how much you guys torture us. Okay? Okay? So ways to affect density, easy. I teach you guys one easy thing. Okay? You see, density equals to mass divided by volume, right? Okay. So if you change mass, the density will change. If you change the volume, the density will change. Okay. You need to remember. Okay. So when you increase the mass, what will happen to the density? Let's say 100. Okay. Let's say density of a substance is 10 grams. divided by 10 cm cube, the density of a substance. Okay, so now what you are doing is the same substance, but you are the mass of the substance increases. The mass increases. Okay, so let's say the mass is 100 gram divided by 10 cm cube. A bigger number, when divided by a smaller number, we will get a bigger number. Always remember, the bigger number divided by a smaller number, we will always get the bigger number. So, if mass increases, bigger number, right? The density will increase. So, increase the mass, increase density. Right? Okay, let's clear. Now, let's talk about the volume. So, we know density equals to mass divided by volume. Let's say now the mass is the same, but the volume divided by 100. If a smaller number divided by a bigger number, you will get a smaller number. Right? You will get a very smaller number. Okay? So, you see, if volume increase, what will happen to the density? Decrease. So if you increase the volume and you remain the mass as the same, okay, what will happen to the density? Decrease. So, okay, this works the other way, right? Okay, so you increase the mass, you increase the density. You decrease the mass, you decrease the density. That's about mass and density, the relationship. Okay, so which has, okay, let me name this as A, let this be B. Which container has more density? B. You guys can answer this. I think I will offer you guys breakfast for this question. We have pressure. Okay. So remember, guys, later, okay, I will, one person can have two breakfasts by just singing the whole song I played earlier. Okay, without lyrics and everything. So I can buy you guys breakfast or lunch or dinner for the whole day. Okay, I can buy you guys meal for the whole day. If you can sing the whole song as how I played it. Can I sing for the first 40? No.
What song?
No. The first 40. Daily package.
The periodic table song.
The song that I played earlier. The periodic table.
I think I know it.
The whole song. Okay, guys, so now talking about, okay, guys, so talking about the volume, just now, remember, when we increase the volume, we decrease the density. If during exam, okay, let's say you don't remember anything, you don't know the relationship, you forgot, you know what you need to do? Logic. If 10 divided by 100, okay, 10 divided by 10, okay, it's a normal. Let's say we increase the mass, what happens? Bigger number divided by smaller number, the density will be bigger. Density increase. Okay, so if, let's say you decrease the volume, let's say I have 10 divided by, okay, I divided by 1, I will have bigger density. If I divide by 100, I will have smaller density. So, you know, when you decrease the volume, you increase the density. Okay, so you don't have to memorize all this. Okay, if I increase mass, blah, 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 no. Understand. Don't memorize, understand. Okay, so guys, raise your hand if it's good so far.
Okay, we have about 36 now, 37.
37, okay. Okay, guys, so I would like to end the density topic because I think you guys remember. Okay, you understand the basic about density, right? Okay, and...
Sorry, This is a bit breaking. Your voice is breaking, Miss Linda.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, now can.
Yes.
Very okay, guys. Cool. So let's talk about pressure. Okay, let's talk about pressure. Okay, guys, what is pressure? Easy. Okay, you know when if I okay, let's say we have a Vaibhav's hand. Okay, we have Vaibhav's hand. If I stand on Vaibhav's hand, okay, so will he feel the pain or not? If I have Vaibhav's hand and I step on Vaibhav's hand, if I stand on Vaibhav's hand, will he feel the pain or not? Vaibhav said yes. So I believe yes. So can you tell me what causes the pain? Won't be much painful because I'm just 20 kg. Okay. Oh no, I'm 40 kg. Okay. So you see, pressure, okay, will be applied by my body weight. My body weight. Okay. Let's say if my body weight is 80 kg, which is not true. Okay. Let's say my body weight is 80 kg and I step on Vaibhav's hand, it will give him more pain. Why? Because my body weight increases. Okay, so the pain is caused by the pressure applied by my body weight. That is pressure all about. Okay, so when I stand on the floor, what happens? Okay, or when you stand on the floor, your body weight, applies a force. Your body weight applies a force. Okay, if your body weight is, okay, let's say, 1 kg of a body, okay, weight applies 10 newton of force. Okay, so 1 kg of body weight applies 10 newton. So since my body weight is 400 newton. Okay, remember guys, this end, okay, should be the unit force here should be capital. It is capital. Remember, guys. Capital N. N for Newton, not N for Nitya. Okay. Okay, guys. So now pressure is applied by our body weight. If we are standing on the floor, okay, pressure is applied by our body weight because our body weight exerts force. Exert force. Okay. So, and where does this pressure apply? Does it apply to the overall area in the classroom? No. Only on the area which is in contact with your foot, which is in contact with you. Let's say if you're lying down, okay, your body weight will still apply pressure, okay, but only over the area in contact with your body. Okay, so here, let me tell you guys something. Let's say I have a box. It's the same box. This box as a 40 kg weight. How can a box weight the same as my body weight? It's okay. Okay, but it has a surface area of 2 cm square. Okay, 4 cm square. Okay, the same box now laid by its side. Okay, so the box is supposed to be heavier than my body weight. Okay, so now this is maybe 8 by 2. 8 by 2, 16. Okay, the pressure applied will be different. Why? Because of the surface area in contact with the object. Okay, this is why. Let's imagine I step on Vaibhav's hand, okay, while wearing a sport shoe. And have you guys seen me wearing my heels? The heels, you know, okay. Imagine I'm just 40 kg. I step on Vaibhav's hand, while wearing heels? Which one will cause more pain? Elizabeth, can which one will cause more pain? More pain. Heel. Okay. You see now, the pain is caused by the pressure applied by the object. What causes the pressure? The weight of the substance. Okay. So the weight of the substance or the weight of the object applies force. Applies force over an area. Okay, so the weight applies a force over an area, but not any area, only the area in contact with the object. The area in contact with the object. Okay, I drew something, but okay. Okay, guys. So this is why pressure is always measured by the force applied over an area. Okay, so pressure applied by the force applied by the area. Area which is in contact with the object. Remember that. Okay. Okay. So force means it's the weight of an object calculated in Newton. 1 kilogram equivalent to 10 Newton. Remember that. Okay. And pressure is calculated by dividing amount of force, okay, by the surface area on which it rests. Okay. Pressure and surface area. I don't want to explain this.
Miss Nitya, sorry, excuse me. Before you go into the calculation, do you think we should share the attendance form?
Yeah, we should. I think Miss Renu, you can share the attendance form with everyone.
Okay, sure.
Okay.
Okay, guys, I'm sharing a Google form link here in the chat form now. The chat, you can see the chat form, chat now. You can see the Google form link. You are required to fill in this Google form. This is the attendance. Okay, so if you didn't fill this in, so consider you're not present. Okay, so please do it. Don't forget, because this is the attendance for today.
Yes, click on the Google form. Click on the Google form. Okay, click on the Google form.
Yeah, you can do it now itself. Yeah.
You just need to choose your name, your class, and your name. That's all.
And submit at the end. Don't forget to submit.
You don't submit? Means you're absent. Miss, can you add my name in this form? Oh, Miss Renu, I think I've missed Bhavesh Sai Kartik's name.
Okay, I'll do that. Student.
Yeah, I'll do. Thank you, Bhavesh.
Where is the folder, this one? Under Science Clinic. Oh, I think I can add it here.
I think there's some problem in the, no? For me, it shows I have to fill a name. I can't move from page 5. Miss Renu?
Yeah, I can. I'm trying to edit editing. I will end. I'm not sure where's the form, but I can straight away edit from this form you send me.
Yeah, because you're one of the collaborators.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I took this from week 4.
Okay. But, I need his name.
Okay, I'm amending the mapping.
Or the one missing. Okay.
Week 4. From the class, they must straight away go to submit form.
Mm-mm.
Because of all the drama that my laptop did.
Mm-hmm. I get his name already. Okay, edit. Then I think okay, ready now.
Okay.
Okay, Bhavesh, I already added your name. You can start. I mean, you can fill in the form now. Try to refresh your page first before you start something.
Okay. Okay, teacher, thank you so much. Teacher, are you translating Malay into cegu, teacher? Guys, sometimes you guys are...
Why you guys are raising up your hand? You can lower down your hand, guys.
Teacher, accidentally.
Okay.
Okay, guys, so what is the relationship between force and surface area? We will get back to Weiberg's hand. Okay, let's say I am on my shoes, okay, and the surface area of my shoes are, okay, 10 centimeter square. This is my sport shoe. My runner's sport shoe. Okay, then I'm on my heels. Heels usually, you know, the surface area will be lesser. Girls, you know better. Guys, you have seen, you should have seen your parents or teachers in our school wearing parents, mothers, okay, and teachers, your sisters wearing heels, right? So, you know, the surface area will always be lower. Okay, maybe I'll reduce it by 5. By half, no? So, we have 10 and 5. Okay, so which one causes more pain, sports shoe or heels? Guys, Daniel said heels. Anna Salva said heels. Samira said heels. Heels. Why? Because when you reduce the surface area, just like how we looked at the relationship between volume and mass with the density, right? Same. When you reduce surface area, the pressure increases. Greater the pressure, greater the pain. Remember this. Do you need to memorize this? No. Okay. Let's say I am 40 kg. I step on your hand. Okay. So it causes pain. Okay. Let's say there is another person. Okay. 80 kg. Okay. Imagine 40 kg on Vibov's hand. It's enough to kill him. He can lose his hand. Unit for pressure, hold on, darling. I'll come back to that when we look into the calculation. Okay? So let's say we increase the body weight from 40 kilogram to 80 kilogram. Okay, 80 kilogram. Okay? So when someone heavier steps on Weiberg's hand, okay, using the same heels, let's say the same 5 centimeter square surface area, okay, when someone heavier steps on, what will happen? When you increase the force, the pressure will increase. You increase the force over the same amount of surface area, you will increase the pressure. Okay? Is that clear, guys? So this calculation... I will speed up a little bit because we have Miss Brenuka's part as well. Okay. I promise to end it in 5 more minutes. Okay. Miss Renu, 5 more minutes. Okay. So pressure, when we look at the calculation, pressure, force divided by surface area, the force will always be in Newton. How to calculate force? Convert weight into force. How to do that? 10 kg or no? Nitya. 1 kg equals to 10 Newton. This is the conversion. Okay. So 1 kg of your body exerts 10 Newton of force. Okay. 1 kg of your body exerts 10 Newton of force. Okay. Divided by surface area. Surface area will be cm squared. This is why I say do not get confused with density. Density over volume. Pressure over surface area. I think you guys will not forget about surface area when if you can remember heels. Heels. Remember heels, surface area, pressure, and Weibull's hand. Okay? Okay, guys. So clear screen, moving on to next. Okay, here let's look at number one. Remember the three steps that I taught you guys just now? What is the first step? What do we need to do? We are going to work out the pressure of the square. Okay, we are going to work out the pressure. So what is the first step that needs to be done? What is the first step, guys? Fast. Guys, first step, formula. What is the formula for pressure? Pressure will be force divided by surface area. Force divided by surface area. Okay, so now number one. Number two, you need to substitute the values. What is the force applied? 132 Newton. It's not even in kilogram. They have converted into Newton. Samira, the unit for force is capital N, Samira. Your answer is correct, darling. But you did some careless mistake in the numbers of force. And your unit for force, okay? So it's 132 Newton divided by 33 meter. So it will be 132 divided by 33 will be 4. Okay, now you need to write Newton divided, right? Divided by meter square. Supposed to be meter square, guys, meter square. Is that clear, guys? Guys, thumbs up if it's clear. Prisha, same. Your unit for Newton. It will be capital N. Okay, capital N. Okay, guys. So let me clear. I wanted to do the pressure in air and water. Okay, so, okay, I'll take 2 minutes here. Okay, so pressure in air. Do you guys know the gravity of the earth? Okay, this is the earth. This is the earth. I'm drawing. This is the earth. Okay, and the gravity is closer to the earth's surface. As we move up, what happens? The gravity reduces, right? Okay? Just like how we are attracted or we are pulled towards the Earth's surface. Air particles, all the particles are also pulled towards the Earth's surface. So, closer to the Earth's surface, the number of particles will be more. You see? The number of particles will be more. As we move up, the gravity weakens and the number of particles will be lesser. When the number of particles are greater, the pressure applied will be greater. Always imagine you walk into a shopping mall, okay, and it's crowded. It's crowded. Okay, you will feel the pressure, right? Always remember this. When it's crowded, okay, there will be more pressure. Okay, here less crowd, less pressure. Okay, this is why when you go for hiking, climb, like you are, if you go for mountain climbing, hiking, you know, why people who goes to Everest mountain, they train for years, because as you go up and up, what happens? The gravity reduces, the amount of oxygen reduces, and you need to train yourself to live or to survive less oxygen. So climbing high mountains, especially Everest mountain, is not a joke. Okay, it needs a lot of training. Okay, so that's the application of pressure in air, the atmospheric atmospheric pressure. Okay, and then moving on to water. Okay, water easier. Okay, so let's say it's uniformly packed. Okay, we have all the particles, right? Okay. I'll explain to you guys about something. Do you know rugby? How cool is rugby? You'll be playing for 1 hour, sweating badly. And when one person falls, what will happen to the rest? How do they get control of the ball, of their rugby ball? They will fall on each other, right? So when they fall on each other, what about the person at the bottom? Who will feel more pain, more pressure? The person at the bottom. Why? The body weight of the people who is on him, who are on him, isn't it? Remember rugby. Here, the mass of the particles above the particles at the bottom, the mass of the particles applies pressure, the force on the particles at the bottom. This is why at the bottom, the pressure will be greater, and it reduces as you go up, because less particles on this surface, less mass, less force applied, pressure will be lower. That's how easy it is. That's life. Okay, guys. So raise your hand if I have pressured you enough with density and pressure topic. I tell you guys something. Some of you guys marked the attendance and left. And some of you guys informed me earlier, so I understand. Okay, Miss Renu?
Yeah.
I will stop sharing, and I'm so sorry to take up, because two topics, right?
Yeah, quite long.
Yeah.
So, okay. They understand that it's more than enough already.
Okay. Miss, who gets the other four breakfast? Guys, this is not the only science clinic that we will have. Miss Renu, you mean?
Okay, we will talk about the breakfast, the other four breakfasts on our next science clinic. Okay. So guys, please don't forget to key in your attendance. Okay, I only received 43 response for now. Supposedly you should have 51 or 52 like that. Okay, so please don't forget to key in your attendance. Okay, so now we will go into
chemistry. Where do we key in the attendance?
The Google form. I will share again the Google form link.
Okay, I think Ms. Renuga, I will share the Google form. I think you can continue with the session. I will guide them.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
So guys, I will go through a little bit. Actually, I want to cover on element, compound, and mixture, but due to time constraint, I think I only can cover up to element, especially the one we recently learned, okay, about the periodic table. So I will just go through that part with everything related about periodic table, okay? So before that, before we go in detail about periodic table, just an intro on the element, okay? Can you guys see the PowerPoint? Can?
Yes, we can.
Okay. So element. So before we go into element, the tiniest particle is what we call as atom. So the element is made up of one type of atom only. So that's what we call as element. Okay, it's like a pure form because they only have one type of atom. Okay, like this copper, carbon, okay, this one all are elements because they are made up of one type of atoms only. Okay, hold on now, why is it hanging? Sorry, what happened to my PowerPoint?
Miss Renu? Miss Pavin is having problem with his computer. Okay, it's okay. Miss Renuga is in.
Hi. Oh, sorry, I'm not sure what happened. Is that any...
Okay, I think you can turn off your video, Miss Renu.
Okay, I think better, right? It's
like... Yeah, better. It will give you a better connection. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, I think I will just show you in this version. If I on the slideshow, it's a bit like lagging. I'm not sure why. So I'll just show you in this version. So element is made up of one type of atom. Okay, that's the basic thing that we need to know. Okay, something like this. Copper, only made up of copper atoms. Carbon means carbon atom, helium, and so on. And atoms, not only in a form of atoms, elements can form in atom form, they also can be in molecule form. Meaning two same atom joined together in molecule form. So molecules, not only for something which is different element combined together, but for the same element also can. So element can be found in the form of atom or molecule. For example, like oxygen, you always form oxygen as, you always write oxygen as O2, right? So they always come together in pair. So that's why we write as O2, but it's still considered as element because they are made up of one type of atom. Okay, that's about introduction on element part, okay? Next, how to write a chemical symbols. Mostly the elements will have the symbol. Okay, the symbols for the elements will be capital letter. Okay, like hydrogen is H, carbon is C, fluorine is F, like that. Okay, sometimes can be in two letters. The first letter must be capital, the second letter must be small letter. Sometimes two letters and the first letter must be capital and second letter must be small letter. And sometimes the symbol can be very much different from what you expect. For example, like Pb is for lead, Ag for silver, which is nothing to do with their current name because they follow the Latin name. For example, like plumbum is the Latin name, but we give another name, which is lead. So they will be different in terms of the symbol, okay? So this is the rules when you're writing the symbols for elements. Okay, this is very important, guys. You cannot write in small letter, especially the first letter. If just one letter, it must be in capital. Because sometimes in exam, we ask you to put the chemical symbol of elements. For example, like fluorine or chlorine or nitrogen or carbon, you must indicate in a capital letter. You must write in capital letter. If you write in small letter, even though it's still N, but you won't get marked. If it's still the same alphabet, you still won't get marked if it's not capital letter. Okay, and if it's two letter, make sure the second letter always is small letter. Like for example, this example here, CO. Okay, CO is cobalt. But if you write capital C and capital O, it means carbon monoxide. It's totally different meaning already, because O stands for oxygen, C for carbon. When it's together, it's carbon monoxide. Okay, not cobalt. If you want to write indicate cobalt, you must put C and O, small letter. C must be capital, O must be small letter. Okay. So far can follow, guys, the naming part. This naming part is mostly from year 8. You learn this in year 8, how you indicate the, how you write the symbol for the elements. Okay, just as a recall process before we go into the periodic table. Okay, so this is the periodic table of the elements. Why I highlight the word elements here? Why is this called elements? Because all these are made up of same kind of atoms only. Like lithium is purely one kind of atom. Beryllium is one kind of atom. So all these substances here in the periodic tables are called elements. Okay, that's why we call this as periodic table of elements. And you can see there are some groups like alkaline metals, alkaline earth metals, you have transition metal, you have noble gas, halogens. Okay, in total, we have 18 groups. Okay, we have 18 groups and can be divided into 7 periods. Okay, if I go in detail like this, okay, period is the horizontal row. Okay, from left to right is considered one period. If from up to down, which is your vertical column, this one is the group. So for a periodic table, we must have 18 group and 7 period. Okay, the group 1 and group 2 are the most reactive metals. One is alkaline metals and one is alkaline earth metals. We recently only learned this under chapter 4. So that's why I'm moving a bit fast here. Okay. So group 1 is the metal, alkaline metal. This is an alkaline earth metal. These two are the most reactive group of metals. Okay. And then this line is the divider between metal and non-metal. And nearby this line should be the semi-metals. Okay. Or known as metalloids. Then group 7 are known as halogens. Halogens are the most reactive non-metals. Okay, remember they are the salt maker. So if you want to make, you want to combine with this metal to form the salt, you always use the halogens. And group 8 or group 0, or also known as group 18, are the noble gas, which are very unreactive. Okay, because they are stable in terms of electron arrangement, they are very stable, so they won't be that reacting with other elements. And then these three, ferrum, cobalt, and nickel, are the magnetic metals. For your information, these are the magnetic metals. And other than that, it's all transition metals. Okay, this is just a refresh on the periodic table. Okay, actually, I want to do this exercise, but then I don't think we have time to do this. I will skip this and this. Okay, you can try this later. Okay. When you get the notes later, you can try this. Okay, I want to go into this part. Okay, the first 20 elements in your periodic table. Okay, guys, for your exam, for your checkpoint, it is necessary for you to know the first 20 elements. Okay, the first 20, at least. I'm not asking you to remember the 118 elements in the periodic table. The first 20 elements is a must. Okay. It will be better if you can remember them in order. Like first one is hydrogen, then helium, followed by the lithium, beryllium, and so on up to calcium. The first 20 elements. And guys, do you remember how we arrange elements in the periodic table? How do we arrange elements in the periodic table? Based on what? Can you guys share your answer?
Increasing what number?
How do we put them in the periodic table? Yes, atomic number, increasing proton number. Yes, we know. Small to big in terms of their proton number, actually, the atomic number. Okay, so that's why you can, when you already know how to arrange them, then you can just calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. Okay. So based on the atomic number, then only you can do the upcoming electron arrangement, grouping, how to put them in period. So that will be helpful for you. So once you already know how to group, how to arrange them according to the atomic number, then based on that, you can do the upcoming questions. Okay, I'll show you example of questions later in Google form. Why is it important for you to know the arrangement and the increasing atomic number? Why is it important? So I will go in detail about that. Okay, now, in a periodic table, you will see something like this. There will be four information written on the periodic table, okay? You will see the element symbol, the chemical symbol of the element, okay, the short form, the chemical symbol, and the full name, the element name, and there will be atomic number also known as the proton number, and you will see the atomic mass here. The 12 is the atomic mass, okay, this part, okay, this is your atomic mass, this one is your atomic number. So atomic number is actually the proton number. And what another information you get from here, if the proton number is 6, you also can determine what based on this proton number. Can you guys share your answer? If you already know the proton number is 6, it will help you to know another number also in the
atomic.
Sorry? Okay, some of you sharing the correct answer, some still confused. Okay, so the proton number is actually same as the electron number. Okay, same as the electron number. The neutron number can be same, can be different, but you have to calculate. The neutron number you need to calculate. But when you see the proton number as 6, that means directly you can say that the electron number also 6. Because the proton number and electron number are equal. Okay, proton and electron number are equal in an element. That's why they are neutral, because the positive and the negative are balanced. Okay, so they have no charge. Unless they are reacting with other elements later, then they will become charged. That one is different story. Okay, for now, you have to remember that proton and electron are equal. The numbers are equal. The atomic mass, the mass is coming from proton plus neutron. As you can see here, the mass number is from proton plus neutron. So if the proton number is 6, then you can actually indicate or you can calculate that the neutron number is 6 as well. Okay, because 12 minus 6. Not necessarily every time you will get the same number. Okay, but you have to calculate. You need to calculate. You need to take the mass minus the proton number in order for you get the neutron number. Okay, guys, can you hear? I'm not sure why Daniel can't hear. Are you guys okay so far?
Yes, Miss Renu.
Yeah, because Daniel said he can.
Maybe it's his internet connection, but I could hear you.
Okay. Okay, so why I put it in a different form here? The up one and down one, actually the same, but sometimes you can see the atomic mass will be down, will be written down. Sometimes the atomic mass will be written up here. Okay, but what you need to consider is the number. The bigger number is actually showing the mass. The smaller number is actually showing the proton number. Okay, that's why I put you two different picture here. For you to know, sometimes the atomic mass can be down, can be written down, or sometimes the atomic mass will be up here. So you look at the number, you see which one is the smaller number. The smaller number will be the proton number. The bigger number is the mass. Okay, then you can calculate accordingly. Then you can determine which one is the proton number, which one is the electron number, and you can calculate the neutron number. That's why it's very important for you to know this. Okay. So that's the thing under the periodic table, how to read the periodic table, especially the info. What are the info you're supposed to get from the periodic table? Okay, next one is the electronic structure. Okay, electronic structure also, we learned it very recently, how to arrange the electrons in their shells. Okay, we already know based on this example here, magnesium 12 and 23. So 12 is the proton number, which means the electron number also 12. So you need to arrange that 12 electrons into the shells accordingly. So the first shell must be maximum 2 electron only. That's the rule. Okay, the first shell must be 2 only. Out of 12 electrons, you only can put 2 electrons in the first shell. Okay, then followed by 8 electrons in the second shell. So from 12, you already put 2 in the first shell. Then second electrons, you put 8. The remaining will be another 2. So that will be in your third shell. But third shell, you can put up to 8. But if 2 is enough, then just stop until here. So this is the electron arrangement, 2, 8, 2. Either you put comma in between or you put a dot. Okay, you put a dot like that, 10. Or you put a comma. Okay, 2, 8, 2 for this magnesium. The electronic configuration, or also known as electronic arrangement. Okay, if you need to draw, then you can draw something like you can see here. Okay, like this. You can put a circle like this, or you put a cross. You put cross for the electron. Usually, we indicate using a cross. When you want to draw the electron, you have to put cross accordingly. 2, 8, 2 like that, according to the electron number. So far, any question, guys?
Miss Renu?
Yeah.
Daniel left due to his internet connection. He is in the waiting room.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
That's okay.
I can't see him in the waiting room.
Now I am the host now.
Mm-mm-mm.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. Okay, so guys, I have included this full way of drawing the electron arrangement for the first 20 elements. Okay, as you can see here, the first one, hydrogen, only got one electron, so got one shell where you can put one electron. Neon, also one shell only, because their electron number is 2, so both the electrons can fit into one shell. Then you can arrange accordingly. But from here, what information you can get from this drawing here, what can you say related to the number of shells? If you look across the period, what you can see in terms of the number of shells? You can see here, this is one period, this is one period, right? Because it's a horizontal row, right? When you see across the period, what will be the same? Here you can see two shells, everything in period 2 will be 2 shells. So that means the number of shells actually determine the period of the element. Okay, if I say, for example, aluminium is 13, the electron number is 13. Okay, so you put like this, 2, 8, 3. So it means got 3 shells. If 3 shells, it will be in third period. 1, 2, 3. Third period. And since they have the last electron as 3, so they will be in group 3. Okay, that's how you determine the group and period. Based on the electronic configuration or based on the electronic structure, okay, the one you're writing here, okay, you can determine the group and the period. Okay, that's another important thing in knowing the electronic structure. So everything starts from the beginning where you know the electron number. Once you already know the electron number, you can write the electron arrangement. Once you already can write the electron arrangement, you can indicate the group and the period accordingly. So remember, the number of shells will indicate the period, which period the element located in, and the last number, the electrons in the last shell will actually tell you which group they are from. Okay? Guys, can I have a thumbs up if you manage to follow up to this point?
Okay, so we have about 7 raised hand and 13 thumbs up.
Okay, let's make 20. out of 45 students, why 20 only understand? What happened to the remaining 20?
I think battery low. I think
too full, too many information, I think.
Okay, there is one question. Okay, guys, so what do you guys do? If you have time, if you can stay, you can ask us questions. Okay, Miss, there's one question from Samira. Miss, I am still confused on the difference between electrons, neutrons, and protons and atomic number. Okay, okay guys, protons, okay, Miss Venu, can I?
Yeah, yeah, can.
Okay, proton number, you know, the elements, right, arranged in periodic table based on proton number. Why? Because proton numbers are, okay, before that, do you understand what is proton number? No, okay. Proton number is the number of total positive charges in an atom. We have an atom, okay, we have an atom, okay, let's say we have one atom, okay. In one atom, we have positive charges, negative charges, and some charges which are neutral. That means no positive, no negative. Okay. So in an atom, the positive charges and negative neutral charges will be at the nucleus. Just like a cell, we have nucleus, right? Atoms have nucleus. Inside the nucleus, we have positive charge and neutral charges.
Okay, actually, you can see the screen now. I'm showing the one Ms. Nita explaining. Okay, you can see this is the structure of atom. Okay, Ms. Nita, can you see the screen?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We can see the
screen. You can explain based on this.
Okay. And then surrounding the center, can you see some circles? These circles are called as shells. This shell contains electrons. Electrons are the negatively charged particles. Electrons are negatively charged particles. Okay, the shells contains electrons. Okay, so these electrons can move around in their shells. Okay, they can also move in and out from an atom. But the positive charge and neutral charges, they can't do it. Okay, then now looking at the atomic number. You know, atoms, proton numbers are unique. This is why elements are arranged based on the proton number in periodic table. If hydrogen has one proton, none other element will have one. If helium has two proton, none other element will have two proton. So proton numbers are unique and they will not move in and out from an atom. So we use this proton number to indicate an atom. This is why we call proton number as atomic number. Is that clear, Samira? If you don't understand, you can ask. I don't mind. I can explain. But one thing, you are not in 2020. You're in 2021. You are not in 82. You are in year 9. You need to change that, your naming. Samira, do you understand? You need to respond, darling. Telling, respond. Yeah, so do you understand? If you don't understand, you can ask me more. Ask me what you don't understand. Neutrons. Okay, neutrons are also particles. So there are three types of subatomic particles inside the atom. Okay, so you see, you will have topics, okay, and subtopics, right? Same. Here, inside an atom, there are some structures. We have three different types. One is proton, positive charges. One is electron, negative charges. And at the center, we have particles which has no charge. They have no charge. Neutral particles. We call them as neutrons. Guys, those who are like who need to leave because it's already four, if you need to leave, you may leave. If you have question, you think this is the chance you can ask the teachers and learn, you can ask and learn. Okay? So Samira, coming back to the lesson, neutrons, okay, neutrons are particles or the tiny balls in an atom which has no charge. There is no negative, no positive. Okay? Imagine we have magnets. If they have poles, they will attract or repel. If they have no pole or they are not magnetized, they do nothing, right? So it's the same. They have no charge. So they remain there in the nucleus, do nothing. We call them as neutral. Neutral means they are not positive, not negative. They're neutral. Do you understand now, Samira? Okay, anyone else? Any other question? Mm-hmm. Yes, Ms. Renu.
No. Just to ask them.
Mm-hmm, yeah. Thank you for asking the question, Samira. I really appreciate your effort. It's a good effort. Really, really, really appreciate. Because you didn't hesitate to ask, just ask. I like your attitude in learning. That's the attitude. Okay. So atomic numbers are special, but are also proton numbers. Proton numbers, we call them as atomic numbers. It's another name for proton numbers. Why do we call as atomic number? Because they are unique. If this one has one, no one else will have one. Like designer handbags. Okay. If they release one design, there is only one design. If you buy and you own them, you are the only one. So that's how special proton numbers. Okay. So proton number means the number which is specific for that particular element. For example, magnesium has 12. None other element will have 12. Okay. So Samira, if you understand, you can thumbs up. There is another question. If you understand, then I can move on with another question. Parisa, okay, means for water pressure, when you put it in a bag and you poke a hole, why do they come out in a different directions? Okay, you see, if you the area where there is high pressure, okay, they tend to be more horizontal. Why? Because the pressure is higher. Okay, the area where there is less pressure, they will come out slowly and less horizontal, more vertical. Okay, it's due to the pressure. Okay, guys, any other question? But Parisa, did you understand? Do you understand, Parisa? Where can we find the slides? Okay, guys, I will amend the slides. I will add and then I will compile the slides from Ms. Renuka. Okay, and I will blast the message on my message. We will do it before Monday. Before Monday. Is that okay? Okay, good. So on Monday, you guys can check my message. No worries. Yes, so if the pressure is higher in on the top, it comes out in a straighter form. Higher than on the top. Yes, yes, darling. Parisa, you are right. The greater the pressure, okay, they will be pushing just like the water hose, okay? The more you close, the greater the pressure. What will happen? They will go further away. They will move more horizontal, further away. If you let it go, that means you don't give them any pressure. What will happen? The water will be more less horizontal. So that's how. Teacher, if you poke a hole in a bottle, fill it with water and close the cap, the water doesn't flow down. Why? Which part of the bottle do you poke the hole? The bottom. If you poke hole, usually the water will not come out because of the difference between the pressure inside the bottle and also the atmospheric pressure. Okay, so whenever you have something, you know, surrounding us, there is atmospheric pressure. Okay, if the atmospheric pressure is greater, that means the water will not come out because the pressure outside is pushing the water in. So this is why the water will not flow out. So any other question, guys? Okay, 4, 5. Any other question, guys?
So the question, guys, related to the periodic table that I already prepared in Google Form, so we can do it as a revision during our revision week. So then we can share in our class and we can do it as an exam rather than doing it now. Yeah, next week onwards, next week and the week after that, supposed to be revision week. Usually 1 week revision, but we put it 2 weeks so that we can make a backup plan, actually. So once we have completed chapter 9, then we can start with overall revision.
Samira, there is a question, Miss. Samira, it's make sure if you are using a scooter, you means a bike or the which one? So whatever. No, I mean scooter. Okay, if you are bringing a scooter to school, you are not allowed to park it inside the school. Okay, you're not allowed to park it inside the school. Okay, so it's on your own risk. You leave it anywhere else, you lose it, you lose it. So it better don't. Better not to bring expensive stuff to school. Better. Because if you lose it, we can't be responsible. It will be a lot of, there will be a lot of hassle for you. Okay, but I understand what you mean. Sometimes traveling is very hard, right? I understand. I told you guys earlier, if you have no question, you can leave. Don't ask me, Miss, can I leave? Can I leave? Okay, guys, we have no more question. You may leave, guys. I think we will end the session. Thank you, Miss Renu.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Nitya, and thank you, students, for joining our science clinic.
Okay. You're most welcome. I'll end because some of them, I don't think so. They are aware that clinic is going on. They're just there sleeping, I guess.